Hello, I am Norbert Gleiche, MD. I am the medical director and chief scientist here at CHR. I'm happy to talk to you today about the subject that quite a number of patients have recently addressed with us, and that is the use of so-called lymphocyte immunization in infertility practice. This may sound strange, but lymphocyte immunization is actually a quite old treatment. 20, 30 years ago, introduced initially by British investigators and very widely practiced all around the world. The concept is a little bit difficult to understand, but I will do my best to explain it. When the embryo is trying to implant for the woman, this is like she receives a mini organ transplant, a solid organ transplant from her partner. And if she were really to receive such a transplant, let's say a kidney transplant, her immune system would violently reject that. Yet, the embryo does not get rejected. And as we have come to understand, the reason for that is that the maternal immune system, upon receiving certain messages from the embryo, once the embryo enters the uterine cavity, the maternal immune system develops what is called a tolerance pathways, which basically make that little embryo immunologically invisible to the immune system, and therefore the embryo is allowed to enter into the maternal endometrial cavity and implant. Now, this kind of a reprogramming of the maternal immune system is dependent on the signals that come from the embryo to the maternal immune system. And those signals, even though we don't know them yet in detail, those signals in turn are dependent on how different the embryo is genetically from the mother. It is almost the opposite principle of really getting an organ transplant. If you want to get an organ transplant from a donor, donor and recipient should be as genetically similar as possible so that there be as little rejection as possible. And here, it's actually the opposite. The more similar the embryo is to the mom, the weaker the signal. The more different the embryo is genetically from the mom, the stronger the signal. And a good strong signal is needed in order for the maternal immune system to reprogram itself. In other words, if partners are genetically very similar, the embryo sends only weak signals and the maternal immune system will not reprogram itself well. And so as a consequence, a number of people decades ago concluded, okay, if we don't get enough of an immune response because the signal is weak, let's amplify the signal. And they came up with the idea that they really could amplify the signal by immunizing the mother with the lymphocytes of the father. Those lymphocytes contain the same antigens that the embryo contains, called HLA antigens. And by doing that, they felt they would amplify the signal and therefore the maternal immune system would respond and induce tolerance pathway, etc., etc. And for a while, as I said, this was very widely practiced, and it has kind of witnessed a rebirth in recent years, but only outside of the US. And the reason is simple. In the US, it's not allowed. And the reason it's not allowed is because the FDA, the Food and Drug Administration, about 20 or 25 years ago, forbade its use. And I must say, we here at CHR, we're actually strong proponents for that FDA intervention at the time, because we in those years were making the point that if a woman who is getting those lymphocyte immunizations from her husband has autoimmunity, and a lot of women have subclinical autoimmunity without even knowing, that lymphocyte immunization will boost that autoimmunity. And actually, paradoxically, cause significant harm to the ability of this woman to get pregnant. And we, therefore, never used lymphocyte immunization on our patients. And we were pretty happy when the FDA prohibited it. Now it's suddenly coming into vogue again. And there are centers in Mexico and elsewhere, in mostly in Europe, but also in Asia, that have started offering lymphocyte immunization again, in principle for two conditions, both requiring good tolerance development in the mother. One is implantation, and two are miscarriages. So a lot of women are again being offered paternal lymphocyte immunizations for difficulty in implantation and for usually repeated miscarriages. We do not recommend it. We do not recommend it for the same reason we didn't recommend it 20, 25 years ago. But we also don't recommend it because, as I mentioned, the Food and Drug Administration is maintaining its prohibition for lymphocyte immunization in the U.S. I hope that has given you some insights on the subject. There are other opinions out there. Inform yourself and reach your own conclusions. But we here at CHR are not big fans of lymphocyte immunization. Thank you for listening.